people are kind to me and a lot of my fans are so fiercely protective of me. In fact, they start abusing anybody who says anything bad to me. I call it my Twitter army. They're all like, how dare you? There were a lot of little things in the film, you know, that really kind of, you know, interested me. Like, for instance, you know, there was this one scene with Nani and this guy who he's chatting with on the bus. And he says that all of us feel like beating up someone or killing someone once in a while. And we satisfy that by watching action thrillers or crime films. So, you know, I wanted to ask you, in reality, like, you know, frustration is something that we deal with on an everyday basis. So how do you vent out your anger, or, you know, what do you do to keep yourself sane?
I think the only time that I get upset or irritable is when I'm pushed too much, when I see a lot of efficiency, or when I feel like, you know, I'm turning cartwheels to make things happen and everybody else is just dreaming and not using their brains. So that makes me very frustrated. But I'm not somebody who gets angry very rarely. I can get irritable or impatient. But the way I deal with it is, no, I don't beat people and I don't kill them and I don't abuse them. But I need to be able to say things. Like, I don't really have filters. And I'm very transparent. So if I'm irritated, you're going to see it on my face. If I'm happy, you're going to see it on my face. And I prefer to just be transparent and tell the person. And in 5 minutes, I'm fine. And if I'm wrong, I'll always apologize. And if I feel that I'm right, unless proven wrong, I will stick to my guns. I can be quite stubborn about it. So I don't know how I deal with it. Yeah, I let myself just be impatient, and then I tell myself that it's not worth it and it's a waste of time, and I just feel happy again. I don't know. Oh, tears is another thing. Oh my god, when I'm angry, tears come out.
Just comes naturally.
Oh my god, yeah. I feel like killing someone, but of course I never will. Like, I don't shout either. I'm not a shouter. So it has to come out in some way, so it comes out in tears.
And, you know, just a few days before the film released, you know, you had put this social media post where you said that, you know, there was a reason why you were kept hidden from the promotions of Wii. And, you know, you also wrote about the memes and the entertaining threats. It's just like a trend that we've seen. You know, a lot of actors have taken a break from social media because of the amount of negativity that is there. How do you manage to, you know, deal with that?
Honestly, all those memes and threats were all very full of love. They were basically saying justice for Aditi. Where is Aditi? How can you hide her? How can you not show her to us? So it was mostly that. Which is why I thought it was very important for me to address them and to tell them I'm here and you'll see me very soon. And it was a collective decision, and it was a decision we took actually for the audience, because right. You know, I genuinely feel as an audience sometimes people tell me too much, and when I'm watching the film I'm like, but you told me everything already. So sometimes I want to watch it for what it is, you know, and let it unfold as it does. So in that case, that's why I wrote that letter that I did. Having said that, each one of those memes is too sweet, too funny. In that 1 week leading up to the release of the film, I felt so much love. And I was like, I felt so missed that it really made it all worth it. I have to say, I don't have any complaints. But if you're talking about social media trolling and negativity, see, there are levels and levels of it. I guess touch wood, people are kind to me, and a lot of my fans are so so fiercely protective of me. In fact, they start abusing anybody who says anything bad to me. So I very rarely have to respond to anything bad, because I call it my Twitter army. They're all like, how dare you? I feel like the way I deal with it is something that my mother always told me when I was small, because I've always been I was a very sensitive child, and I continue to be very sensitive. So my mother always says that, you know, the only thing you have control over is actually your own actions and your own attitude and yourself. So always be the best version of yourself. And if somebody behaves badly, literally look at it as their problem. Like, there is something they are suffering. So today I try to be Florence Nightingale, and I'm like, I hope you feel better. I'm sending you a hug. I hope all this, like, what else can I do? I mean, I can just laugh about it and just like give some love. I mean, literally, that's all I can do. I don't have. What's the point of me also getting angry in the middle of it all? And then it just like leads to more negativity and more rubbish, and I don't want it.
Okay, Aditi, thank you so much. It was lovely talking to you, and
thank
all the best for V and for all your upcoming projects.
Thank you. Nice talking to you.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.